Dennis gave me free pick and mix. Bonbons and all, no fucking about. Like, we're basically celebrities now.
We're like the course.
Can I be Jim?
It's too much, Erin.
I can't handle it. I think I'm going to crack.
Okay, look, this has got way out of hand. What are you wearing? What did I say? You look like a fucking ball bag.
Your hair's all funny.
I just put a bit too much mousse in it, that's all.
Listen, girls.
Get off me.
Will you listen? It was piss.
What was?
The tears on the statue. Well, I actually have good reason to believe they were actually dog piss.
No, you're not serious.
Deadly serious.
Sweet and gentle Jesus. I mean, that sort of makes sense. I'm not even sure I saw her smirk anymore. I've had a lot of caffeine.
I definitely didn't see her smirk. I was lying, so.
Excellent.
I was going to tell you all earlier, but then Peter showed up and there was just this instant connection, like a spark.
There was no spark, Erin.
He said it was special.
He also said your dead pet had been fucking resurrected, so you know, pinch of salt.
Yes. And now he's talking about digging him up. And when he does, he'll realise that Toto has not, in fact, been resurrected. He'll realise that Toto is just dead. Very, very dead. And we've all been talking shit.
We need to tell the truth now.
No fucking way. This is the best thing that's ever happened to me.
Look, Claire. Take a long, hard look at that. And this is only the beginning. The Derry Journal are on their way round. They said we can make page 5.
Erin, tell her!
Yeah, we could tell the truth. But I sort of like the fact that Peter thinks I'm the chosen one, so.
James!
I have a slight concern. The truth might affect my friendship with Peter.
You don't have a friendship with Peter?
Yes, I do. We have a lot in common, Claire.
Like what? I mean, apart from the fact you appear to be wearing his clothes?
Like the fact that we're both very spiritual, but mainly the fact that he doesn't think I'm a dick, and neither do I.
Come on, people! The jig is up!
Doesn't have to be.
What's become of us? What has become of us?
Keep an eye on that kitchen window, you.
I want no part of this.
Well, you're in too deep, now, Claire.
I mean, we're stealing a body.
Let's just get it over with and never ever speak of it again.
Jesus Christ, my nails are fucking ruined.
Less talking, more digging.
I've got something.
Okay. Give it here. Right.
Me and Michelle go stash him somewhere, and the rest of you will fall it back in.
Open the box, Erin.
God.
Yes, he is with us. Do not be afraid, child.
Listen, I can.
Oh, no, actually, I can't. I can't explain.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
James?
All right.
What is going on?
Trying to throw Clive out?
Clive? Who's Clive?
Christ.
You dirty, dirty Brit.
Beg your pardon.
I know what you're up to.
I'm not up to anything. I should be up to something, but I can't find the person I'm supposed to be up to it with because this place is like a fucking maze.
You'll scare Clive.
Who's Clive?
Clive. Clive is a wee prod from East Belfast. Clive came back from Ibiza, got on the wrong bus at Aldergrove Airport, then fell asleep. Clive woke up in Derry, surrounded by Russians and Fenians. Clive is absolutely shit himself.
So where's the real Artem?
Giant's Causeway, probably. Foreigners fucking love the Giant's Causeway.
I just want to go home, but she won't let me leave.
She won't let me leave.
I also think Clive may have had too many disco biscuits on his holidays.
Oh, here we are.
Thank God. Whatever you do, don't slag off the Pope. We're outnumbered.
For God's sake, Orla, you're going to make yourself broke.
I can handle that.
James, what is going on? I wait a long time. You no longer want to do sex?
No. I do want to do sex. I really, really want to do sex.
Come.
You disgust me. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Piss off, Erin.
I mean, I know you're desperate, James, but paying for it.
What?
You really thought I wouldn't work it out?
Work what out? What the actual cock are you talking about?
I'm talking about the fact that she's a prostitute.
I am prostitute?
Oh, come off it, James. She's charging you for it, hasn't she? Just admit it.
No, I mean, I don't think so. I mean, not that I wouldn't consider it.
Ugh. How dare you? I am poor Ukrainian, so I must be prostitute.
Hear me out. First, she comes on to James here. What would possess her? Financial gain, that's what.
He attractive boy, Erin.
He's English, Katya.
I have no problem with this.
You should.
Secondly, she owns condoms. They're in her bag. A whole packet, I've seen them, people.
You are imbecile.
An imbecile. And thirdly, all night, we Ukrainian fellas have been coming up and giving her money they owe her. How the hell do you explain that?
I organize, how you say it, whip round. We like to buy Jenny a present to thank her for a nice party.
Oh, you guys.
Right, okay. Yeah, that does sort of explain it.
Dickhead.
Really, Erin?
So not only you insult me, but you have also spoiled Jenny's surprise.
I think you should leave.
But great evening all the same, Jenny. You're a credit to yourself.
Sir?
Sir!
Oh, dickhead.
Please, sit down.
Okay, ladies. I'd just like to ask you a few questions.
Nice uniform.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Well, now, Michelle.
Okay, sir, I would just like to state for the tape...
There is no tape.
...that we are completely and totally innocent, and this is a... horrific miscarriage of justice.
Grant.
Excuse me?
Here's where we're at, girls.
I'm actually a boy.
Okay, love. We've had several reports of suspicious activity on the grounds of Our Lady Immaculate College this evening. Following up on that lead, we discover you five on the premises, that the locks of the side door have been forced and the alarm system deactivated. Now, we can't get hold of the headmistress, Sister George Michael.
George Michael?
But the caretaker has informed us that a substantial amount of computer equipment seems to have vanished.
We didn't take it.
What were you doing on the grounds, girls?
We went there too. We thought that we could. We were just trying to.
Reagan.
We would like to speak to a solicitor, please.
All in good time.
For the tape, the inspector is refusing us the right of legal representation.
There is no tape.
Why can't we speak to a solicitor?
I didn't say you couldn't.
Oh, you're trying to stitch us up, aren't you?
Why would I do that?
Because we're Fenians.
That is a very serious allegation, girls.
Are you denying that your organization is prejudiced, Inspector? For the tape, the inspector is refusing to answer.
There is no tape.
If your organization isn't prejudiced, Inspector, then... Oh, you won't mind telling us how many Catholic officers are serving in it at this time.
I think we're losing sight of who's questioning who here, girls.
How many?
Well, if you count the Jewish fellow from Ballymena, 3.
In the entire police force, you have 3 Catholic officers, and one of those officers is a Jew.
Lovely fella, by the way.
He is, yeah.
I would like to speak to our lawyer immediately.
Who is our lawyer?
I don't know.
Look, we're just trying to work out what happened here, girls.
It was Hans.
Hans?
Hans and his friend, they did it.
Hans?
You know, like Hans Christian Andersen.
His mother was Danish.
Do you think you could describe this Hans?
Well, I could pick that or sort of a lineup.
Let's hope it doesn't come to that. Okay, before this goes any further, you're minors. We need to get a parent or a guardian down here ASAP. Who would you like us to call?
Can you just give us a minute?
We can't call mine. Well, we're not calling mine.
Mine neither.
Do not look at Orla. Her ma is just an extension of my ma.
What about someone's dad?
Dads can't be trusted.
Dads are in the pockets of mess.
It's true. Dads are just my enablers.
Well, who then?
Oh, God. There's nobody. They'll just wear us down until we say we did it. We force aside false confessions.
What if we wear them down first?
Oi.
I know who we should call.
So, assessing myself, says I, Column, who'd be ringing you at this hour? And sure, if I hadn't been in the middle of a Maeve Binchy, I'd have probably slept through the thing altogether.
What was it we asked him?
I can't remember, sir.
Jesus.
I'm like a dead one.
Mr. McCool, if I could just... Your nieces and their friends claim they saw the men who carried out this burglary.
We did see them.
They've given us some rather vague descriptions.
Hardly vague.
I apologize, Miss Mallon. You did provide us with quite specific details of the suspect's rear end.
Apology accepted.
We also gave you a name?
Nobody in Londonderry is called Hans, girls.
Well, you say that now, but there's a young lad up in Pennyburn called Diego.
Is this relevant?
The mother, she's a Derry woman, but the father, he was Spanish, though not on the scene, by all accounts.
Thank you. If we could just... Alex, don't leave me.
According to the
is
mother,
he, himself, sir?
Diego's father, this is. Well, he came over with the Spanish Armada, then cleared off, leaving her to raise the wind on her own. But that story didn't totally add up, was the thing.
I need you to stop talking, man.
The problem being that the Spanish Armada landed here in 1588, and that the son, Diego, as you call him, well, he was born more than four centuries later.
I will caution you.
She made the whole thing up. As mad as a bag of cats she was.
Sir.
And she had been clattering the wind in non-fake tan stuff to make him more Spanishy looking, you know.
There's a van matching the descriptions on CCTV.
Which is how suspicions were raised, you see, because there was a powerful whiff off the wee crater.
That'll do it. Thank you very much for your time. You've been a huge help. We'll take it from here.
We can go.
Yes, please. Do go right now. And for the love of suffering Jesus, take him with you.
Thank you. You're a legend, Colin. A legend.
Thank you,
Colin. Anytime, Wayne. Anytime at all.
Look, this is too important. I'm going to that concert. I'm not afraid of a fucking polar bear.
Me either.
No, me.
Bastard.
I'll kill it with my own two hands if I have to.
Bring it on.
Yes.
Okay. We seem to have gone down a weird road here, people. I think we just got a bit confused. We don't actually have to fight a polar bear, and if we did, I wouldn't really fancy our chances because, well, they're massive. Oh,
but there's five of us.
The point is, the polar bear's not the one stopping us going to the concert. It's our mothers, and we'll never get them to change their minds.
We're not gonna try and change their minds. We're gonna do something else.
What?
Lay our holes off. We're not going to get caught, Claire. Because as far as our minds are concerned, me, you and James are around Erin's, and Erin and Orda are around mine.
But we're not around yours, Michelle. We're on the bus to Belfast.
I can't. I cannot explain it to her again. I'm going to scream.
What's in the suitcase, Michelle?
Vodka.
You brought an entire suitcase full of vodka?
No. There's mixers as well. I'm not a savage. You can mix vodka with cider, right?
Oh, God, I am boiling.
Is it any wonder, Claire? What are you wearing? Yeah, you look like a fucking provo.
Look, I don't want anyone recognising me, okay?
No one's gonna recognise you, Claire.
Claire Devlin, is that you?
Jesus Christ.
Relax, Claire. It's the weekend. She has no authority over us at the weekend. She has no right to question us. And if she tries to, I'll tell her as much.
Morning, girls.
Morning.
Morning, Sister Michael.
What takes you to Belfast?
I'm not really sure that...
Speak up.
I'm not really sure that that's any of your business.
I'm going to assume... That was an ill-judged attempt at humour, Miss Quinn.
Yes.
Now answer the question.
We're going to the museum.
Which museum?
Ulster Museum.
What for?
A project. A history project.
What about?
Ulster.
Spin is getting out of control now, girls.
It's Grand Claire. I think she bought it.
Of course she didn't buy it. She's on to us, I'm telling you. God, I'm sweltered here.
Then take it off.
I can't take it off. There's nothing underneath it.
What? Not even a bra?
Jesus, Claire, you've no bra on.
Of course I've got a bra on.
I haven't got a bra on.
Can everyone please stop saying bra?
But I can hardly parade around in just my bra, can I? I'm not Madonna.
Isn't that the truth?
What's she doing now?
Reading her book. Now she's looking at the woman beside her. Now she's getting up. Now she's coming this way. Now she's standing right in front of us.
What's she doing?
Now she's...
Stop talking, James.
I want to sit here.
What? What? Why?
Well, you're just such wonderful company, girls. What with your stimulating conversation and razor-sharp wit.
Really?
No, not really. The woman next to me is eating an egg and onion sandwich. And the smell of it is enough to turn an orange march. Christ, but this is heavy.
Sister, no, let me...
What do you have in here, girls?
It's not ours.
Not yours?
We have never seen it before in our lives, have we, girls?
Never.
Excuse me, everyone. Can I have your attention, please? Does anyone own this red suitcase?
No.
Now, let me be clear. No one can claim this bag. Is that correct? I think we have a code red on our hands. Driver, pull over.
Jesus!
Hey, this isn't great.
It's not that big a deal.
They're about to blow up an entire suitcase of vodka, Michelle.
I know. Animals.
Their wee beekeeper costumes are so cracker.
You're unbelievable.
This is so itchy now. Don't blame me. Blame the mug tree man.
This is really serious, Michelle. People have gone to jail for this.
Why is this place so mental?
That's enough, James. You have serious fucking anger management issues. Do you know that?
Bravo, this is
31 Alpha, over.
I hear you, over. All clear here, over.
Roger, let's pack it up, over.
Powerful smell of vodka down here, over.
Vodka, did he say? Interesting.
Okay, we need to go.
Not actually believe this. I'm missing David Tomley's gig, Michelle.
And all because of that manager, motherfucker.
I swear, if you say motherfucker one more time.
What's wrong with you?
This is your fault.
Why is it my fault?
You're the one who threatened it first year. You're the one who gave Jenny Joyce the finger.
I'm desperate now. This is agony.
Can you please stop crying in my face for 5 fucking minutes, James?
I feel awful. I think my body's gone into starvation mode. I think it's starting to shut down.
For Christ's sake, Claire, you've just basically skipped lunch.
Orla, that better not be what I think it is. You better not have brought my diary to school.
I have to. I'm doing my book report on it.
Give it to me!
No!
What's going on there, girl?
She has my diary, sister, and she won't give it back.
I'll take that. Sit down. Mr. Maguire, you have been warned. Do not ask me again.
This is disgraceful. I should have access to a lavatory. What about my civil rights?
Coroner. And you, give that here.
Fuck, sister.
No.
Shouldn't you put that in the confiscated box?
Quiet.
What am I going to do, Erin? That collar's been discontinued.
This is torture.
Michelle, I can't hold it in any longer.
What part of me not giving a flying fuck are you struggling with exactly? Oh, look, your boring fucking diary sent you to sleep. I'm taking my lipstick back.
Michelle, you can't do that. It's stealing.
She stole it first.
Michelle, don't.
God.
Jesus, that's disgusting. Stop it.
That's English for you fucking savages.
Don't look at me
like that, Erin, you'll get your £2 back.
But will you ever get your self-respect back, Claire?
Right, if I leave now, I might still catch David.
What if Sister Declan wakes up?
It's funny how she sleeps with her eyes wide open, isn't it?
What?
Sweet suffering Jehovah.
All right. Boo!
Where'd you get all this?
Vanilla's cupboard. I think she might have a bit of a problem.
You think Vanilla might have a bit of a problem? Put it away and get back downstairs now.
Well, sit yourselves down and have a wee drink.
No, Michelle, it's wrong.
So are those ski pants, Claire, but that doesn't stop you pulling them over your hole this morning. Wait for it.
Michelle!
Don't be such a sure of boar bags. Slaunch a motherfucker!
No, 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 no!
Wow.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how dead do you think we are?
Older fella. Well, it was one of the two. Anyway, he says to me, says he, they're not.
This is the truth, Mommy.
Erin, if you expect me to believe that Michelle tripped while carrying a scented candle, you must think I come up the foil in a bubble.
My uncle still finds it all quite difficult to talk
it's
about.
My bit, it's my bit. What are we going to do?
Oh, for God's sake, Mary, would you look? You're missing my big moment.
Two gunmen of roughly the same height kicked his door down and tied him to the radiator with his own shoelaces. He barely had those shoelaces a week, John. They threatened him with physical violence. They threatened to burn his house down.
Why would two gunmen break into a chippy?
Ah, I'm really hot.
You're such a pussy.
What were they looking for?
Chips, obviously.
They were looking for the keys to the van. Keep up, Erin.
Do you think we should knock them about a bit?
No.
Nothing drastic, just a few slaps.
I said no, Sarah.
What? Not even the wee gay film?
I'm not gay.
Okay, that should do it. Really?
I hate to be a health and safety stickler, but surely you're not actually planning on leaving us like this, are you?
La mer.
Back door. Back door. Back door.
On va danser le long du golfe clé. A des reflets d'argent, la mer. Les reflets sont ronds.
Machette, it's locked.
Au ciel d'été.
What the fuck's going on here exactly?
Okay. All right. Well, what happened was, Michelle was carrying the Santa candle.
It was difficult, so you've just given up. You might fail, so why bother trying?
Exactly. Told you she'd understand.
Have you ever stopped to look at these? These faces from the past. They're not so different from you, really. They had dreams like you do. They had ambitions, but now they're gone. Dead. Dust.
That's my Auntie Anne, third from the left. She's not dead. She's only 54. She runs the mobile library in Ballymacorte.
Quiet. But did they fulfill those dreams, those ambitions? One day, girls, you too will just be an old photograph in a hallway. You only get one life. Don't be afraid to live it. Find your voice.
make your mark.
Sometimes the river flows, but nothing breathes. A train arrives, but never leaves.
Dig deep. Something you hate, something you despise. No holding back. Come on! Get it out!
Injustice!
Yes!
Prejudice!
Good! This is good!
School! Piano lessons!
For the people here use the word we to describe things that aren't even actually that small!
God, but I love that accent, James!
You will shine. You've got to search for the hero inside yourself. Search for the secrets you hide. Search for the hero inside yourself. Until
Mr. Brin's amazing.
I've just never met anyone like her.
She's an inspiration.
Absolutely. She really knows how to grab things by the balls.
Oh, yeah. She's changed my life. She really has.
She likes my accent.
A day for her.
I think I would too, you know.
Me too.
I fuck it, why not?
Yeah. I mean, obviously, I totally agree. I'd die for her as well. But I'm also conscious of the fact we've only known her like 2 days.
And?
Well, this is a bit weird. She's invited us around to her house at night.
What do you mean?
Well, she's a teacher.
She's much more than a teacher.
Yeah, no, obviously, I get that. She's great, but it's just that I have a feeling I might be sort of frowned upon.
God, Claire, you're so conditioned.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means you need to loosen the fuck up.
I am loose, thank you very much.
Face it, Claire. You're a crack killer.
Not a crack killer. I am not a crack killer!
Some wine.
Oh, no, actually, I don't. Cheers. Happy again.
Okay.
You don't have much stuff.
Everything I own can fit into a suitcase. I've never understood why people weigh themselves down with meaningless crap, you know?
Yeah, God, I just hate possessions so much.
Does that mean I can have your Sylvanian family collection?
Shut up, Orla.
I don't like to feel tied down, you know? Life should be spontaneous. Free.
Big time.
Sláinte.
This is actually nice.
Mm. Tastes a bit like blood.
Life is no brief candle to me. It is a sort of splendid torch which I've got hold of for the moment. And I want to make it burn as brightly as possible.
That's beautiful.
Sure. It's my favorite quote.
Take it easy, Oliver Reed.
What's yours?
Be careful, child, of the doll made of glass. For if you hold her too tightly, she will break and you will bleed.
I don't think I'm familiar with that one. Who's it by?
Me, it's by me.
Wow.
This is the rhythm of the night.
I feel all floaty.
She's absolutely fucking flying.
Well, well, well. What are you guys up to?
Nothing much.
We were just hanging out at Mr. Brin's house.
You were at her house? At night?
Well, that's a bit inappropriate.
Your ma, is it a bit inappropriate?
That doesn't even make sense.
Your ma doesn't even make sense.
Is she drunk?
Your ma's drunk.
Okay, Claire. Yeah, I think we get the idea. Oh, lovely seeing you, Jenny.
Take care now.